каждом маленьком ребенке, и в мальчишке, и в девчонке, есть по 200 грамм взрывчатки или даже полкило. Должен он бежать и прыгать, все хватать, ногами дрыгать, а иначе он взорвется, трах-бабах, и нет его. Каждый новенький ребенок вылезает из пеленок и теряется повсюду, и находится везде. Он всегда куда-то мчится, он ужасно огорчится, если что-нибудь на свете вдруг случится без него.
Hey everyone, welcome to Scum of the Earth Live. I'm starting this the moment I have a chip stuck in the back of my throat. Do I cough in the mic? So for those of you who have never joined us before, you know this is one of the most professional streams on the internet. Welcome back to Tomba, everyone. It's Tomba. He's back again. You might notice we last left off. I had continually fucked myself over. I didn't know where to go. And I was constantly gaming over. I was able to reload a previous save. Damn it, I should have said reload last save. I was able to reload a previous save. And get the items necessary, but have a few more lives left over. So I'm back where we were when we left off, except I have two lives instead of, I think, zero. Psycho Fox is in the chat. Vivian Harper is in the chat. They're commenting on the fact that I started the stream off by clearing my throat. So let's go get some shit before coming back. I've been doing the bosses out of order, it turns out. Whoopsie doodles. Oh, and of course the game is running like shit. Great! The stream is already off to a fabulous start. So I have a bunch of stuff to address. First of all, sound. It's really fucking hot here in Texas. I have to do these streams without any of my air conditioning or fans on, or else you're gonna hear brrrr during the whole time. Well, I guess because I have my air conditioning and my fans off, my PC fan is kicking up. So if you hear a bit of a whirring or buzzing in the background, I do apologize. Looking into fixing that, pretty much just need to get some longer cords and play with my computer across the room instead of right next to me. It's an amateur mistake. Normally when we do live streams with multiple people, I put the game on the big screen and I have Andy check the chat on his laptop, and that makes things a lot easier for me with a lot less distortion. But when I do solo streams, I need to be able to be by two monitors at once, which means I have to be closer to my computer. It's a bunch of shit you don't need to know. All I know is, sorry for the sound sucking, I'll fix it. Second thing, you might notice I'm actually having this stream, which means my computer did not die. What's the old adage? Whoa! Is that a boss battle? I'm not ready for that. I think the old adage is rumors of my computer's death are greatly exaggerated. The locals call it the leaf slider. It's on two leafy bones. I'm sorry, but I can't let you go any further. It's a little dangerous. Crying won't get you anywhere. Leaf slider. Starring John Leafs Davies. I don't think any joke I'm gonna make tonight is gonna be better than that. Good night, everybody! Vivian Harper says, oh yes, live streaming with Tomba, with a hot, sweaty man. Are you trying to say I'm an attractive, sweaty man, or I'm hot and sweaty? Yeah, I ate the mushroom, let me go. Oh no. He said crying won't get you anywhere, so I have to cry. It's reverse psychology. Hey, there, don't really cry. Don't call his fucking bluff, you dumb fucking dwarf. He's one of the three dirty dwarfs. He's the relative of clean dwarf, though. Let's race that penguin. Everybody. Okay, and it's more like pen trisalon, I think. So I've learned some things about myself while playing this game. Most notably, I don't like Tomba. I said it. I fucking said it. I grew up loving this game. You know, what before recently, if you asked me my top 10 PS1 games, this would be in that list. Now, it's like, wow. I don't know if it just... I don't think it aged badly, because graphically, it looks great. The soundtrack is amazing. And normally when people say things age badly, it's in relation to either visually or stylistically. Or mechanically. I don't think what this game sets out to do is bad. I just think the formula is bad. The philosophy of gaming is bad on this one. You know, it's more of, like I've said, I think in the last stream, this isn't a platformer. This is a adventure game you jump in. But it could have been done better. That's me. Taking it off the list. Will Klonoa hold up? Is the question I'm too scared to ask, honestly. I know I gotta combine these two flowers, but I don't know how to use that blue powder. I'm just trying to do all these side quests to get more health. That's a major thing that I kind of blundered. If I have more health and more lives, I think the rest of this Let's Play will go swimmingly. Also, if I learn to swim, because Tomba still doesn't know how to fucking swim. Okay, maybe I have to stand next to a flower. The thing said red plus blue. Oh! Moon Tiara Magic, there it goes. It made a coconut? Ah! Oh god! What happened to you? Holy shit! Oh god, and I'm so super fast, I'm out of control. Oh bugger. This might be a little too crazy. Vivian Harper says, when you actually play the game, you know, your nostalgia for it wears off and you remember the fine details. I don't, maybe it's just because I'm streaming it. I found this out. There are some games that are fun to stream. There are some games that aren't. I don't think this is a one to particularly... It might be fun for you. I don't know. In the comment section, say if it's fun or not. You know, convince me to play something else. I'm also think I'm getting that point in my old age that, oh wait, secrets. Will the secret make me change my opinion on Tomba? And how he's too goddamn fast. Tomba officially faster than Sonic the Hedgehog right now. But then again, who isn't? Even in Smash Brothers, Sonic isn't the fastest character. Jesus Christ. Hell yeah. Okay, I think just one more of those, and I'll go fight some bosses. Damn fucking pigs. Speaking of pigs, there are some pigs. I found out today that we have officially reached 911 subscribers. That's right. I hope you all remember where you were the day Scum of the Earth hit 911 subscribers. I'm gonna get up and get down and remember that 911 subscribers is a joke in my town. I should have reached 911 subscribers a long time ago. Psycho Fox is saying that he likes it when we hate the games, because, Schadenfreude. But there's a difference of a game you hate and a game that's fun to stream. There's a lot- oh, and I fucked it up. There's a lot of games that I hate that I will admit are much more fun to stream. Because then, like, you're kind of in on the joke, you're kind of mocking it. Where this, I think... Yeah, the jumps call for a certain amount of attention I cannot give it when I am trying to talk. I'm coming down with a bad case of the Let's Plays. One could so... Nope. Okay. I cannot waste a life, so... Nope! And I did. And I fucking did. He's fucking dead. Tom is fucking dead. And he's not gray anymore. He regained his humanity. See, like, it's little things like this. You shouldn't have to flop on your belly on top of the pole and then fall off of it and then grab it to connect it. I feel like any other game, Tomba would instantly connect with that pole. Nope. Chat's going in a weird place. They're talking about Michigan J Frog for some reason. As you know, with solo streams, I sadly cannot give the attention to the chat we normally give with Andy being on the computer. But I believe Andy might be in the chat, so if you want to holler at him, he's Melody Burst. He has his own YouTube channel where he does his solo Let's Plays, which is Melody Burst here on YouTube. I believe he's playing through Spooky's Mansion. It's kind of a spoof on indie jump scares games. Oh, that's fucking dirty pool, old man. Dirty pool. Oh well, I'm up to 6 lives now. Whoop. Yeah. Yep. And don't go too fast, Tomba. Or Tombi if you're Japanese. Narwhal Entertainment is here. That's Merrick D'Amato. Which, of course, is Italian for the tomato. Which is weird because I thought tomato was an Italian word. Yeah, save my data. Hey, Chris, what's your favorite episode of Star Trek Next Generation? I'm glad you asked that, audience. No one asked that. We don't want to go down that road. Just heal me up and get me on my fucking way. How's the sound, by the way, and how's the audio quality? Video quality. How's the sound? Also, how's the audio? Whoa. Fucking... Okay, I'm gonna go to the dwarf village and do some quick quests. I don't know, I mean, this game's alright. This game's fun. Maybe it's my frustration is causing me to hate it. You know, it's one of those instances where you're bad at a game, so you don't like it. Like, I can understand why people who suck at Smash think Smash is garbage, you know? It's why if I was playing BlazBlue, I'd probably go, man, this fucking sucks. When really it's just me hating myself for being bad at BlazBlue. Also, call it BlazBlue, you fuckers. BlazBlue. You're missing an E, you stupid cunts. I'm sorry. That's a lot of just anger out of nowhere, Chris. Oh, so back to what I was talking about earlier, my computer. I put a big Facebook post saying about how, regrettably, we might be going away for a little while. And that's because last time I had severe computer problems, it took months for it to get fixed. Because the people at the repair shop thought it was the motherboard, then they thought it was the graphics card, then they thought it was the power supply, and I ended up having to pay for all of those to be bought and installed. And it drove me nearly to... bankruptcy? I don't have a lot of money. I'm actually very poor at the moment. Hopefully my foray into game design will change that, at least give me enough walking around money. Which stinks because after the Kickstarter, I can't use any of that money for personal stuff because that's unethical, which it totally is. So I have to wait till after the Kickstarter and after the game actually hits retail, because I can't keep any of the money that's not generated from the actual full retail of the game. So yeah, so I left this big post saying, hey, we might be going away for a while. I'm really sorry about that. But I had my friend come in, and he thinks it was just the CMOS battery, and he popped it out. It's still having some problems, so the motherboard still might be damaged, but it's running now, which before it wasn't. Before it was just bricked. So, you know, I of course jumped to the conclusion, hey, it's fucking dead. I'm gonna have to wait another few months to get this fixed. So luckily it's up and running. That being said, while it's not dead, it's terminal, which is kind of a rude thing to say, but I mean, if we're using the phrases alive and dead to describe computers, what do you call something that's dying? Well, it's terminal. But it also is a terminal. Think about that. Anyway, it's terminal. So sadly, the Kickstarter is going to have to incorporate funds for a new machine to build the game on. So that is just... So let's go on to the good news, though. I have been working on some... Those of you might know, I do intros sometimes for OSW, OSWReview.com, the old school wrestling review with Jay Hunter, OOC, and V1. So like whenever you see old school Nintendo stuff pop up or pixelated wrestlers, that's normally me. I chip in, Jay will contact me or I'll contact, you know, whatever. He got me in contact with another prominent YouTube group. I guess I should drop some hints. I did a little quick thing for them, but then they contacted me to do some more. So you might be seeing some of my artwork appear on other people's shows. I guess here's a hint. At first there were two, and now there are four of them. You could say they did a switcheroo. And that's all the hint I'm giving. Don't guess it in the chat! Don't ruin it for everyone. Andy in the chat is saying our game is going to be better than Shenmue 3. It's going to be funnier than Shenmue 3. I don't know. I think Shenmue does have some amazing cutscenes, and if they keep that up, Shenmue might be funnier than our game.
It'll be years before you can face me.
Yeah, get the fuck out of here, old man. I get all my Shenmue knowledge from Donkey's Let's Play. It's probably why I said there'll be years before then. Yeah. I never actually played Shenmue. I was never really interested. It just seemed really boring to me. Then again, I didn't have a Dreamcast and was big on Dreamcast, and I was already kind of checked out of Xbox when, I think it came on Xbox when they did the Shenmue 2 re-release. Okay, now Andy's saying our game's gonna be it's only going to be slightly worse than Bloodstained. I think that's a lie. I think Bloodstained will be much better than our game. Funnier? No. Mechanically speaking, probably better. Just a little bit. This is our first game where we're going against someone who created a genre. Or not created, perfected. Metroid was before... See, Castlevania, I think, was before... No, I think Metroid was also before Castlevania. But Castlevania also was an arcade game. Doesn't matter. The first time the Castlevania franchise became a quote-unquote Metroidvania was Symphony of the Night, which was well into the PS1, whereas Metroid was always a Metroid. So when you say a game is a Metroidvania, you're really just saying it's a Metroid-ish game. Metroid-ish. These guys are fighting over something... A fucking vase. Who gives a shit? So I think last time I asked you folks, what are some of your favorite PS1 games? Anyone else have any suggestions of games I can go back and maybe I had a fond remembrance for and then I come back and I'm like, wow, this is dog shit. Tell you what, Einhander, while hard, holds up. That game is still... Man, I play that and it still as awesome as I remember it. Symphony of the Night holds up. Klonoa, we'll see. I have a plan to go back and play Klonoa sometime soon, so. Here's your fucking Voss. Uh-oh. Fucking Gandalf appeared out of nowhere mad that someone broke his vase. Oh, I filled up the hole, so give me the point. And I left. See, I didn't do that. It just did it on itself. Like, Tomba just instinctively knew. Nothing more to do here. I filled up a hole. I broke up a fight between guys fighting about a vase. My work is done. And then Tomba went to his home planet and died on the way. Ah, Coca-Cola. Proud sponsor of Scum of the Earth. Oh no, I'm fighting the world's greatest thief, and purportedly the world's greatest lover. Yep, and he's back down here. Look at those fucking sideburns. He's got some fucking Jeff Hardy hair.
You must be the little squirt that blocked my tunnel. Look at me. It's all your fault that I'm back in here again. I was trying to escape from the dwarves right when you filled my tunnel with dirt. Forget the mansion treasures. I can't even steal a slice of bread now. Say, did you know about the telescope at the watchtower? No, never mind. Oh, it's so boring in here. I'm going to sleep.
They didn't put you down here, bro, to serve out your time. They put you down here to die, because I don't think they're bringing you food. I mean, you're in a hole behind a house. Do, 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 Tomba, Tomba. I think that's all I have to do. No, there's one more thing I gotta do. Fuck. Yeah, this fucking lady hid something in the forest. I gotta go give. Get. I gotta get to give to her, and I think I remember how to do it. Did I read a guide before doing this today? Yes, because I didn't want a repeat of last episode. We're going to try and defeat two evil pigs today, folks. Probably by, I would assume, blowing down their houses. Luckily, one of them's made of straw and one's made of twigs. So. Oh, shit! You fucking claw grabber. Okay. Give me that Wawa. Give me that sweet, sweet Wawa. I do love how Tomba climbs. How he's like a cat on furniture. Come on, come on. Oh! There we go. Tomba. Tomba, come on. I'm a mad motherfucker with a bucket of water. You do not want to fuck with the Tomba. Okay, so now that we got a bucket of water, we have to think, What would be in this forest that would necessitate us using an entire bucket of water? I'll give you a hint. It's something I lit my fucking ass on fire earlier on. I cuss too much. I apologize. I don't want to be one of those guys. I come off as an angry video game guy. I'm too angry in my real life to be fake angry at video games. Fangry. And it's a baked yam! Truly, this is a treasure worthy of kings and gods. Look upon my yam, she mighty, and despair. And Alexander wept, for there were no more yams to cook. It's a bagel, someone in the chat said. I think that was Merrick. Yeah, it's a yam, lady. I fucking got your yam. Take it. Oh, that what I was quoting before, in case you were wondering, is the Shelley poem, Ozymandias. Really, game? Wait, here it comes, everyone. Okay, that is... because it was a little squeaking fart and not like a big fart, that actually is really funny. It's like a little gust of wind.
I had so much gas, I felt like I was going to explode!
Alright! So... I don't think people in the chat got the joke. Ozymandias. I put the word yam in it. No, not Mary Shelley. It was her husband, Percy? Is it Percy Shelley? Andy, you're in the chat. Help me out. Mary Shelley's husband, the actual writer who could write. Unlike his wife, who kept a dream journal of bullshit. Am I a fan of the Frankenstein book? No, I think it's fucking terrible. But then again, I hate most romantic writing. And now what you're gonna say, I wouldn't consider Frankenstein a romance. No, it's from the romance period, you fucking dummy. That's when they fucking wrote about trees. Here's the problem with Frankenstein, the novel, okay? Three fucking pages describing fucking trees because Dr. Frankenstein goes in the woods to commune with nature. Ugh. Whereas the monster gets like half a paragraph. It's like, oh, he's gross looking. There's a lot. I hate that book top to bottom. Top to bottom, I hate that book. I could go on. Why the reasons I think the universal monster story of Frankenstein is better, dare I say, more realistic. Because if you put a guy together out of dead body parts, he's not coming out a super genius who learns the English language by observing a bunch of people in a fucking house while he's in a closet for 4 weeks. Or German. I can't remember what language he learned. I can't remember where Frankenstein's from. Geneva, right? Isn't he from Geneva? Or does he go to school in Geneva? I can't remember. It's Switzerland, I believe. Yes, okay, remember what I'm doing. I'm going to fight an evil pig. I'm not going to discuss the flaws. Percy Bysshe Shelley, thank you. Wrote, so I was right, it was Percival. Let's see what's up here. Oh, hey, that fucker. Okay, I'm just gonna put this out right now. I've thought this since I've seen this kid. He looks like a cross between a Teddy Ruxpin character and that guy who cuts off Vegeta's tail in Dragon Ball Z. I think his name is Yajirobe. Yeah, okay, so he wants the butterflies I've been collecting this whole time. I hit the wrong thing. Oh, god damn it! I hit the wrong thing! Someone's taking umbrage with my thoughts about the Frankenstein novel. It's a weak piece of shit. That was written because someone had a nightmare. Hey, you know when people say don't listen to other people talk about their dreams because they're boring? Why am I gonna read a book about someone's dream? Oh! Also, that's... we all know that's just marketing, right? Oh, we're having a ghost story contest, and I took a nap. And when I woke up, I had the most frightful dream that was oddly intricate. Other problem I have with Frankenstein is the whole fiance murdered brother angle that happens in that book. I think it's really mishandled, and I think a lot of characters are introduced very slapdash and quickly just so the monster can kill them off. I think it's weird that the monster is like this super genius, like Dr. Moriarty, like he's fucking framing people. It makes more sense for him to be a brooding, hulking monster, you know? Father, why did you curse me so by making me so fiendishly smart? Now we're going to fight in Antarctica. Or wherever the fuck the climax of that shit story takes place. Am I saying I could write a better story than Frankenstein? No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying anyone could write a better story than Frankenstein. Okay. Back with a vengeance. This time I'm doing it. Now let's talk about Beowulf and my Beowulf shit. At least Gilgamesh teaches you about friendship. I'm just gonna put that out there. Sorry, me and Andy had this bit about how much we hate Beowulf. Whoa, where are those fucking butterflies I gave you last time, bro? Did you eat them? Oh wait, no, I didn't give it to him, I flew away. That's what happened. I don't even remember my own life! Silo's late! Maybe because you were too busy staying up last night playing Heyday till 4 in the morning. I know that because I played with you. Silo's not the first on the stream, so he failed. Everyone make fun of him for his tardiness. Mock him openly. Just kidding. It's good to have you, Silo. Oh, Lord, it's me, Christopher Biscuits. I'm back. Why is there slowdown in a PS1 game? That's clearly emulated. Also, another problem I'm having, I'm using an Xbox controller that has the worst D-pad in history. I'm burping, I'm just... I don't care anymore. You know, I just don't. If this was like a Let's Play done proper, you know, I'd be editing it and I'd be taking out the burps and the coughs. And the evil pigs. Okay, let's fight this evil pig, everybody. Oh, Silo was at work! He had a jobby job!
Wow, how did you get in here? This area's off limits to all else except me, the stormy evil pig.
Am I gonna fight the black stormy evil pig next?
The only one and only master of storms. It's not a place for little people like you. Now, take you and your funky hair out of my sight. My storms create havoc for everyone!
Is that a question?
All the better. I do as I please. These great storms are masterpieces. A gold bracelet? Why, yes, gold is beautiful. What's the problem with collecting it? Behold this ferocious storm. I am the ruler here.
This was also written by Shelley.
Don't ever underestimate me. I'll see to it that you understand who's in charge here.
Okay, the object is to have the most boring boss fight in the history of games. I think I can accomplish this, folks. Oh, so close. I gotta get it in the bag. See, I collect the pig bags and throw the pigs into the bag. Which I think is kind of stupid that you can't reveal the boss battle until you have the bag. Because I thought that'd be like another way to fuck the player over royally. Is if you get these boss battles and there's no way to actually beat them. Okay. Oh! So close. I was going to make a joke, but someone in the chat beat me to it. Psycho Fox is saying, I'm Bizarro Stormy. I'm regular Stormy.
I'm helping. Bizarro, I love you.
Okay.
No! Oh, damn!
It is a lot harder than it looks. And that it looks simple as hell, and I'm still messing it up. Okay. Nope. Mm-mm. Come on, Chris, get your head in the game. You trained for this all your life. Dark Souls was just a field day compared to this. Oh! Technically, I don't think that should have worked, but it did! That is one evil pig down, everybody! Claxons, buzzers, bells! A triumphant jubilation of cherubs in the sky, trumpeting the arrival of the first boss's defeat! Tomba the Liberator! Tomba the Conqueror! And Tomba cried for there were no more pigs to fuck up. Hey, buddy. You see me beat that evil pig? I like your style. How about you and me go back to my place?
Back in Village and back in Lake are on the other side of the Mushroom Forest.
Never mind. Oh, I think there's a secret down here. Or not a secret. It's a secret to everybody, except people who play this game. Should that be my gimmick? Like I'm the burping Let's Player?
Morty! Oh, we gotta get out of here. This guy playing Tomba.
Bop, bop, boo. Okay. Playing it on the safe side here, everybody. I still haven't given that dog his medicine. I feel terrible. Let's go fight our second boss. Because the wind is gone. But there's still lava. Oh yes, tend to me, old man.
As if I was Jesus of Nazareth. And you're Sam of Cyrene. Or better yet, you're Jesus and I'm Ben-Hur. Ben-Hur? I hardly know her. I wish I was going to Bauhaus Village instead of Bacchus Village. The bats have left the bell tower. Nobody gets this joke.
So, we're gonna hit 1,000 subscribers soon, and I think I know what game we're gonna play, but I would still love suggestions. Should we have a vote? Or is that something dangerous? Because last time we had people vote on a game, that disreputable fiend Jay Hunter gamed the system and made us play one of my most hated games. I say that disreputable fiend Jay Hunter, and yet he's the one who helped us get that far in the first place. Okay, so we've been here before, but now that I have the pig bag, it will reveal the pig door to fight the pig. So I eat the magic mushroom. Because I know a lot of people wanting us to play Deadly Premonition. Is that something you'd be interested in seeing? And I say Deadly Premonition because I've literally have people buy me the game on Steam. Josh sent me a copy on PlayStation. It's probably our most requested game. And one of the big reasons I want to play it is I feel like a lot of people who play Deadly Premonition haven't watched Twin Peaks. And so they're all like, oh, wow, this is so weird and out of nowhere. Why is this like that? And we'd be one of the groups to actually have seen Twin Peaks, and we can compare. Recently, me, Jason, and Andy have all watched Twin Peaks over again. We can compare beat for beat the different elements of the game, which are homages and blatant ripoffs, depending on who you ask. You ask most people it's an homage, you ask me it's a blatant fucking ripoff.
My, whoa, my clothes, this happens every, I can't handle this today. Who are you? Why are you all so shirtless? Oh God. I guess you should see my muscles rip through my clothes. You know, people like you never know what they're getting into before it's too late. Let's fuck. What do you think you can do, skinny boy? Go home while you still can. I'm into baby bondage BDSM. What? You still dare to fight? That's it. I've had enough. I gave you your chance. You're in for it now. Just remember, you asked for it.
Oh, buddy. Oh. Oh, shit. Lava Mancer. And there's a rope here. Okay. Come on, you evil pig bastard. Okay. They don't come down randomly. There's a... Like, they are actually coming towards me. This is a deliberate attack. I feel like this is no longer, like, a playful sexual game between two consenting adults. I feel like this is an aggressive attack on my person. I would request you stop throwing lava rocks. That's not my... I'm not trying to kink shame, but it's just... It's not my thing. Get in that fucking bag. That's my thing.
Hop in the second. Call me daddy.
Oh. Fox is angry because I don't use the Wii U he sent us to stream any games. Well, if Nintendo wasn't pricks about shutting people down when they stream games. I streamed one Nintendo game once and I got shut down. First time. During my birthday party, of all things. See, if you stream a first-party Nintendo game, there's that whole rigmarole, DMCA, Run DMC, whatever thing. And there's no non-first-party Nintendo games worth a shit on the Wii U that I can think of. And if you guys want to see us play Tank, 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 then yeah, I got that. That'll be good for 12 fucking minutes before everyone gets bored and turns the stream off. I can't see what's going on in the chat. There's too many birds. Okay. Well, now the good news is we can go to the lava caves because there's no more wind and there's no more fire. So I think this is going to be our third pig. Oh my goodness. It's only 7:45. What happened? Did I just magically get better at Tomba? I saw what? Yeah, look at my fortune. What do you see? Typical. So this guy needs cheese. A guy needs butterflies. Yeah, that's not enough cheese. Narwhal asked, can we stream a Kinect game? I need to get some better equipment. Part of the reason why we never finished our Let's Play of... I can't remember the name of it, so we'll just say... first-person survival horror game for Kinect that's shit. Never-ending Nightmares or something like that. The reason why we never finished that game is having some major camera problems, and it was just really hard to edit. I've got a backup camera, and I think we'll be able to facilitate that better, but we're really struggling with some of our equipment. So, in the future, maybe? Let me put it this way. Let me walk you guys through how we did the Rise of Nightmare, or whatever the hell, I think it was, maybe it was Rise of Nightmare. How we did the Rise of Nightmare Let's Play. Jason stood in front of a green screen across the room from me and Andy. He had his own personal boom mic on him. We used to have a okay boom mic that worked for its purposes. It has since broke, which is why we need the money to get a new boom mic, which will hopefully be a much better boom mic. That's what we're doing with the Kickstarter. About $800 of that is going towards a NTG3 by Rode, which is a very good boom mic that we desperately need, especially if we're making a game that uses nothing but videos. So Jason had his own microphone. Me and Andy were on the opposite side of the room, watching him play the game, and watching on a secondary monitor the gameplay footage, and we used our little Yeti microphone to record our audio. The problem was, though, is that since they're on two different frequencies, ours being a Yeti, his being a boom, and them being so far across the room, there was terrible echo. So I had to manually go in and delete any audio coming from me and Andy when Jason talked, and any audio coming from Jason when me and Andy talked. So it was a very hard process to do that first video. With the boom mic being broken, there's no way to record Jason's audio as well and Andy and myself's audio. So until that is resolved, sadly, Kinect games have been put on indefinite hold. Bunga! Bunga hungry! Bunga! I really hope in the Japanese game his skin is supposed to be blue as well, but I have a sad feeling I don't think it's supposed to be. Let's not say that Chris Vaughn is a hypocrite here. I complain so much about Pen Pen Trisalon having quasi-racist stereotype, and this does not look good in this game. I forgot all about this. If that offends you, may I please remind you, I did not make this game. I do not support the views that Tomba has. I'll look it up. Hopefully he's blue in the Japanese game as well. If he's... No! Oh! Wasted a life to get a life. Damn fucking pigs and fucking parasols. Pigs and parasols, the Tomba story. Ooh. It's a lunchbox. Delicious savory meats. Oh, fuckers. I might be ditching this parasol. It sucks. Like, it's fucking up the timing of my jumping. Okay. Let's go talk to Funga again. Is Funga mean fungus? Does he want a mushroom? No, because that healing mushroom is an actual item that you use. It's not like a quest item. I can try. Okay, someone in the chat is saying Funga is always blue. Thank God for that. Then I'm the racist. Okay, let's... There was an episode of the Kinnikuman anime that had something kind of similar to Funga. And I remember just being really uncomfortable watching with a group of friends because I had built up like Kinnikuman being like one of my favorite shows. And they're like, this is one of your favorite shows? And I was like, I was unaware of the antics in this particular episode. I greatly apologize. Okay. Well, back to work. You were just working. Was that tunnel for pleasure and this one's your real tunnel? It's a fun tunnel. Yeah. It's the world's largest glory hole for the world's biggest dick. I don't know why Don Pardo's into the world's biggest dick, Bobby Moynihan. With your host, Tomba. Musical guest, Paul McCartney. These fuckers. I hate them so much. Get away. Go away. Shoot. Made it. Crush your hearts, hope to die. It's time to take on the third evil piggy. Ooh. Uh-oh. Music here reminds me kind of a Demon's Crest for some reason. I guess it's the harp. Look at this fucking dweeb.
You're wondering how I can stay up here without burning up. Well, this particular spot is shielded from the heat of the lava. Anyway, it's not important. I have bigger things on my mind right now. You can't tell this to anybody. I lost a very important item that I was taking care of for my boss. Promise not to tell a single soul. I hope you're not live streaming this on the internet. I thought I lost it somewhere around here, so I came back to look for it. But it's so hot and dangerous, I just can't seem to find it anywhere.
The treble thief. Oh, I thought he was a pirate. I gave him a pirate voice for nothing. I am racist. I'm racist against pirates and mythological jungle dwellers. Oh, there he is.
Well, what have we here? A funny-looking kid with ridiculous hair. The owner of the haunted mansion? Who knows? Who cares? We rule the mansion now. You're challenging me to a fight? I'll give you a fight you won't likely forget.
9/11. Subscribers. Oh, fuck. Holy shit. I'm not going to forget that. Jesus Christ on a crutch. For an atheist, I sure drop JC's name quite a bit. Also, as an atheist, please go to my vape blog. That's an Alex Navarro joke. I feel bad about stealing that one. Oh, wow. Okay, lunch bag time. I'm gonna eat my lunch, then I'm gonna eat your lunch, buddy. Wait, is eat your lunch a sexual euphemism, or is that a... Who cares? I got in the sack. Merrick, what's your idea? You have a Goblin's Den idea.
The Haunted Mansion! Cleared!
And it is now... exactly the same, but a bit cleaner, I guess. Ooh! Oh, wait, no, I want the parasol this time. I talk so much shit about it, I need it back. Well, I'm just fucking blazing through this game now. Can't remember how many evil pigs there are. I say that, I just fucking cursed myself, didn't I? I'm blazing through this game. This thing's gonna last like 100 more episodes. They're gonna pull a Castlevania, like, those weren't the real 7 evil pigs. You have to fight these upside down 7 evil pigs.
Ride the pig. Ride the pig. Get that treasure.
All right, I think that means I can fly that bird somewhere else.
Whoa!
Hell yeah. 7 lives. Let me up there. Let me up there. Come on. I can see it. I can. There we go. Just gotta ride that piggy.
They're talking about Dario Argento in the chat. And Psycho Fox says, I prefer Dario Sargento, the famous cheese magnet.
Alright. 8 lives, Tomba. You did it. Let's go see that. Is the bird this way? I want to say I remember the bird being this way. I remember getting on the Phoenix's back, like... Ah! The bird! It's dead! Okay. I think I know what to do. I'm gonna have a bunkhouse buck match. Wasn't Bunkhouse Buck Terry Funk's tag team partner? One of his terrible WCW stints? That fucking colonel in the white suit? And now we fight the Mana Fortress! I am almost certain I've made that reference before, but I don't care.
Wario Argento! I'm making the movies!
I get my daughter to take her top off.
Oh, these guys are bad guys? Yeah, I can hit him. Oh, I don't know how to feel about these guys. I don't know if I'm just being too sensitive, but it's starting to unnerve me a bit. I can only speak what I feel, and in my heart of hearts. Ooh, Funga Drum. Okay, so I gotta go back and give that guy the Funga Drum. You know, normally I need a cream to get rid of the Funga Drum, you know what I mean? Oh, that's not cool. That's not cool. That's not cool, game. And you throw me into another one? Oh, holy shit.
Ah, go away, please. You're not one of the Mascari. Whew, what a relief. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. I came from the clock tower that's in the village.
Are you trying to insinuate the Mascari are not civilized? Fucking white devil. Look at this fucker in his ball haircut. Or is that a coconut on his head? Uh-oh. Charles stole a dude's hat. What a fucking asshole. I'm gonna tell all the villagers. Oh, wait. Speaking of assholes. Hey, buddy, I got you. Yeah, you fucking suck. There's entire guides online dedicated to finding you. That's how good you are at hiding. Oh, gimme. 8 is pretty great. But I think 8 is enough. Get back up there. I think the dad from 8 is enough died today, actually. This just in, gross guy on stream gets grosser by the minute. This just in. Gross guy on stream sucks a tomba! Get, ow! Oh god! People, moratorium on self-promoting during my stream, please. Jesus Christ. I'm not gonna say their name, but someone who I've never heard before just popped in to say, check out my channel. Go leech on someone who's actually successful. I've got nothing, man. Come on, Tomba, you're embarrassing me. Tomba, you dick! Yeah, I think I cursed myself by saying I was brazen. It was pretty brazen of me, honestly. I think I saved here. Let's try loading up. Let's reload last save. I did it right this time. Meh. None of my business. Meh. Okay. Okay, so I got the Funga Drum. Oh, that's... Look at that! A tiny itty bit of that drum you can see. I don't know about you Funga people, but back where I come from, we call that some old bullshit. Okay, I talk to this guy again. The Village of Civilization. Their king for life is Sid Meier. Theme song by Justice. Beating of a million drums, fire off a million guns. Just cut to a bunch of buffalo jumping off a giant stone head. Oh. Gotta get Dickhead again. Hey, Dickhead. Yeah, I caught you. Get the fuck out of here. This is Tomba's house. This game's not Dickhead hide and seek. That game was on N64. Oh, God. So I had an interesting idea for a series today. What if we did alternate history video game stuff? Like, what if things were different? And we avoid the obvious stuff like, you know, oh, I got caught. Are you kidding me? Oh my god, that's a game over! Oh my- Fuck this game! Anyway, I was gonna say we'd avoid the obvious stuff like, what if the Dreamcast was successful? Or, you know, what if Sega won the war? Pretty much we'd probably avoid Sega altogether. I'd like to do like, what if Iggy's Wrecking Ball was the most profitable video game of all time? The reason why is I had a dream the other night that I went to an alternate dimension and the only difference was, history split when Iggy's Wrecking Ball was released and it became the most popular game of all time. What if Iggy's Wrecking Ball was as influential as Call of Duty was? Like, Call of Duty, and I'm not saying Call of Duty is like such a great game, but you have to admit that for better or worse, the philosophy of design in major publishers changed with the success of the Call of Duty franchise. You know, that's why almost every game is a shooter, be it third person or first, more often than not first. What if that same kind of thing happened, but with Iggy's Wrecking Ball, or something equally preposterous? The world where Bomberman 64 was more important than Mario 64. Fuck you guys. I am falling for that shit again. I am getting that butterfly, though. So thanks for that. Thanks for these bananas. I'm sure I've met someone who needs bananas. I don't remember at the moment, so I apologize if I forget you. There's Charles. I gotta see him about someone's hat. Okay, Charlie. You know why I'm here. Charlie, give me the hat. Oh, really? We gotta play up to this stereotype? I gotta give the monkey bananas? This guy has civilized conversations with me all the time, and I know him. Dare I say we're friends? If someone found my backup pants and I split my pants, I'd call him a pal. Charlie? Charlie? Save me, Charlie! Thank you, Charles. Wow! Pretty progressive game. A monkey that doesn't like bananas. I like it. Oh, and see, that guy thinks Charles is a piece of... Charlie, I'm so sorry. I feel for distrusting you. Okay, I gotta get Charles a smoothie or something. I wonder if I have anything to drink in my inventory.
Okay. And just gotta get that fruit. Oh, okay, whatever, still served my purpose. I'm gonna consider that a win. I'm not gonna consider that a win, though. That's a lose. Wow, don't sneak up on me like that. Did you find my hat? Yeah, I found your fucking hat, you crybaby. Here's your miner's hat. Okay. I guess we're gonna play Clock Tower now, everyone. People in the chat, I agree with Psycho Fox. Mary Shelley's Frankenstein should have been about Iggy's Wrecking Ball instead. Whoa! Pretty swank digs here you guys have. Is the ice cream truck coming? That's the only excuse for that kind of song in this. Now I want ice cream. No, it's not. It's Santa Claus. Santa Claus is coming, everybody. And he brought ice cream. It's the clock tower, and I got to fight my incestuous grandpa at the top with the magic arrows. Okay. Well, that was fun. Now loading. I'd love to see a Mega 64 skit. Rocco just jumps on people in a pink wig. Actually, I think there might have been a Tomba Mega 64 skit. Okay, well, I'm about to call it a wrap here. But before I do, wrap up my wounds, old man. Just the way I like them. Whoa! Stylistic change. Was not expecting this. Happy, upbeat music. I guess it's no longer haunted. Someone's playing the electric banjo like it's folktronic. I feel like listening to Finnegan the Folk Hero. Oh, this is where these thief guys live, is in the Haunted Mansion. So why'd I help these disgusting miscreants? He's perpetual breaker of man's law. Of God's law as well. Because they are thieves of life. I saw him shank a kid just for looking at him crossways. Hey, hat people. You gonna play some Hattress? Psycho Fox says folktronic like Cotton Eye Joe. God damn no! Oh man, that takes me back to PE class and not even middle school, elementary school. Play that song all again. Folktronic was a Momus album, and whenever I have to introduce people to Momus, that's normally where I start. That or the Little Red Songbook. It kind of helps digest the later weirdness of the man's career.
I don't know what my favorite Momus album is. I'm very partial to Oscar Tennis Champion. That's a really good one. Otto Spooky and Aki Milk are also really good. Jomus, his mashup with one of the guys from Gay Against You, was pretty good. Funga? What's a funga? Can you drink molasses? I don't think you can. I don't think Charlie would be very happy if I was like, oh, here, I got you something to drink, and it's just fucking molasses. Whoa! And I'm eaten by the disgusting flower from Pink Floyd's The Wall, the movie, the ride, the game. I don't like what Psycho Fox is insinuating about the career of Momus. Assuming that I was insinuating that he wrote the techno remix of Cotton Eye Joe that was oh so popular here in Texas in the 90s. And I guess abroad. I thought it was just a southern thing, that we were so fucking backwards down here in the south that a techno remix of Cotton Eye Joe became popular. I'm like walking around with my rap albums and I'm like, man, this shit doesn't happen in New York. Okay. Dare to dream big, Tomba. Okay, so I think I gotta find that pirate's missing booty down here. He lost something, he said. Something that belonged to his boss. Whoa! There's a platform down there. But does it lead anywhere? Guess what, folks? It leads to nowhere. There's a platform to nothingness. A disappointment. No! Oh, Tomba, you... See, I get mad at Tomba, not myself. That's the funny thing. Like, I'm sure if someone else was playing this, I'd yell at them. I'm that big of an asshole. Like, I'd be like, Jason, no! Ah, oh, God, Jason, how'd you miss that? Whereas, when there's no one to blame but myself, I invent adversaries. Next time, I'll be like, oh, my dog walked in, and yeah, he bit me, and it made me drop my controller. Why would my dog betray me? See, yeah, that's exactly what happened. My cat walked across my keyboard. I don't even have a goddamn cat. And I never will. Should I tell the cat story? Should I save that for a different stream? And I'm dead again. Ladies and gentlemen, Chris Vaughn, the worst Tomba player in the history of everything. History of the World, Part 2. Not only will have Hitler on ice, it'll have Chris Vaughn fucking up on Tomba. Oh, signature move. I'm getting back into the groove, everyone. I'm getting into the groove because there's a boy who I have to prove my love to him. Before I, you know he's mine.
Ooh, Tomba!
Whoa. Nope. It didn't fall over yet. That's the game's fault, not mine. Vivian Harper says, don't worry, Chris. You're still cute, so you have that thing going for you. I am now convinced that Vivian thinks that I'm Andy. Next she'll say, at least you're not the fat bald one with the bad teeth. Who's short and ugly and now dead. The music, maybe it's just me, but I feel like the music is getting slower each time, like, mocking me. I think I'm psyching myself out. I think I'm at the point where I'm doing so bad that I won't be able to recover. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo! I think that's what we all come to see here, folks. I think that's what we all come... I think when we see Chris play Tombo, we come to see him fall down a hole. And game over. I think that was a successful stream, because that's what we all came here for. I'm glad I could facilitate... No, I don't want to watch the intro again. I'm glad I could facilitate my demise for you. Vivian says, nah, I know which one you are. Oh, face. Oh, I'm a cat, meow. Hi, I'm new. Hi, I'm a cat, meow. Why'd you walk over my keyboard and ruin my game? See, I told you I have a cat. He's in the chat room. And he's become sentient! I'm sorry, I'm a cat. We're actually stopping the stream for now. I'm sad that you came in towards the end. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter to know when the next stream will be. I wanted to have the Duck Game stream Saturday, but as we all know, my computer fried itself. Tomba, you're so adamant about me watching this intro. I'm going to have to change channel. I'm going to have to go to this thing. Okay. So, Facebook... We're on there, facebook.com/reloadlastsave. If you're new and confused why this is Scum of the Earth, yet our Facebook is Reload Last Save, Scum of the Earth is the name of the channel. Reload Last Save is the name of our production company, which not only produces fine video programming like this, but soon video and board games will be coming out from us. So Reload Last Save on Facebook, Twitter, also Reload Last Save. Our website, reloadlastsave.com. Subscribe today to become part of the Reload Last Save Goblin Brigade. And how can you be a good goblin? By getting more people to follow us and subscribe to us. See, I feel bad for I'm a cat. He's upset that he's late. And it's like, sir or madam or cat, I apologize. Psycho says, check out their Harvester Let's Play if you haven't. It's a good place to start. Then I would probably go to Sanitarium. Watch the beginning and end of the Broken Sword Let's Plays. You can skip all the middle. I'm just kidding. And then straight into some of our best work, which would be... I Have No Mouth and I Must Scream, and Clock Tower 3. Those would be my top picks. Though a lot of people are partial to the Dracula series. They really like our Dracula games, which would be Dracula 1, 2, and Legacy of Kain Blood Omen. I consider that a Dracula game, for all intents and purposes. By the way, starting a new channel called Intensive Purposes, just to piss people off. So like I said, if you want to be a good goblin... Join the Goblin Brigade by subscribing and following us on social media. But more importantly, we got to get this channel bigger. I don't want to have 9/11 subscribers forever. It makes me uncomfortable. Well, I'm a cat is like saying, I'm subbed. I mean, pejoratively, if more new people come in. I don't think pejorative, I'm using that word right. Whatever. I'm closing the stream down for the day. Hopefully soon I can get all four members of the group. That's right, Graham's still in the group. He's a specter that haunts the halls of Reload Last Save. Hopefully I can get all members of the Scum of the Earth together to play Duck Game, which is amazingly fun. And I will see you all soon. Good night. Good night. And Good Luck is a movie you should watch.